Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. So today we are doing a full set of nails with the pop-off method. I did go ahead and put my tips on. I have my gel peeled base coat, what is it called, the peel-off base coat already on and ready to go. I just decided to skip through this part to make this as fast as possible. But yeah, so let's get into it. We're gonna go ahead and use our monomer from Nail Craze, shopnailcraze.org, and this color right here is just a mixture of a couple of different colors and things. And actually I was trying to see if I was gonna decide to use it and to make sure it was enough, so I just poured a little bit of something else I had mixed up together in it, and we're just gonna make it do what it do, because I have to get rid of all these mixes because I just have too many of them lying around. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get this application out of the way, and then I'll be back when it's time to file.
Hey, y'all say, yo, y'all say, and they lingerie on that Chardonnay, it's going touchdowns on your runway. I'm Texas forever like Barbara and I'm Rambo and yo. I'm billionaire like John Jack, I'm Camo and yo. These thoughts can't clock me nowadays. You wish I was your pound cake. Boy, you know I look good at four. Wish I was your baby mom. Want me to go around and give you good karma, but no. We escalate up in this bitch like elevators. Of course, sometimes shit go down when it's $1 billion on an elevator.
Of course, sometimes shit go down when it's $1 billion on an elevator.
Looking this good,
goddamn, goddamn,
and I would.
change it if I could.
If I could, if I could, if I could.
And you can say what you want on the shit.
On the shit,
on the shit, on the shit, on the shit. Oh, everyone to feel like this
tonight.
Think about you.
If it's loving that you want, then you should make me your girl, your girl. If it's loving that you need, then baby, come and share my world.
All right, so now I'm just checking to make sure that the nails are completely dry, and we're gonna start filing with our 8080 grit from Panna. I do get these off of Amazon, if you guys should already know by now, and I get them in a pack of 50 for $25.
Like a side.
All right, once we are done with the hand file, I am going to go ahead with my 150 grit sanding band. These are from Panna as well. They are the zebra grit. I personally like the zebra ones better, so that's why you'll see all of my files, they are white. But yeah, and I did move my drill bit up some. I used to do this, but I was trying to see if I still liked it, and I don't. So I just, you're going to see me move it back down because, I don't know, I just don't care for it anymore. It's not as sturdy when you have your drill bit set up like this. I don't think the drill is meant to hold the bit correctly like that. So, yeah. I tried to see if I still liked it. I didn't like it. I don't recommend. So, yeah. Let's just go ahead and seal these cuticles up, and we're gonna go ahead and buff the rest of the nail to make sure that it's completely smooth. If you guys have watched my videos before, you know that I don't buff my nails. Not unless I'm doing like chrome or something like that. I just use a sanding band and it gets the job done for me. I don't have any scratches or anything in my nail, and it just cuts down the amount of bits I have to use and the amount of time I do on my sets. So I just recommend getting a good grit for your sanding bands, and you can use it for multiple things in your routine.
Baby, my Valentine, yo. Can I hear the making my temperature the rise? If you leave me, I could die, I swear. You are like the oxygen I need to survive. I'll be honest. Your love ain't it, don't leave me. I am so obsessed.
All right, so once we are done using our e-file, we are going to go ahead and lay down a layer of base coat. This one is from Beatles. I do lay down a little thin layer of base coat when I'm doing nail art. I do find it easier to work with, especially like when I'm drawing and stuff like that. It's a better surface to work on than just like a buff surface. So I do recommend using base coat, but I do also recommend wiping it off the tacky layer because it can make things spread and move around if you don't.
Looking at it with a
All right, so we're just gonna go ahead and start laying out colors for this look. I think this color is called Blazing Orange, and it is from IGEL Beauty. So I do like IGEL. I really don't have that many of their colors, but I think I'm gonna get some more because they always have a sale, and they work pretty good if you ask me. So yeah, I'm just getting all these colors ready. This is just black from D&D, whatever they call, you know, the regular decor schmugglers. And then we're gonna bring out white, and those are pretty much our three colors that we're gonna work with today. And this is from IGEL Beauty as well, and as you can see, baby, this bottle is done for. But I feel like I just need to get as much as I can out of it, so yeah, because we ain't trying to waste no money. All right, so we are gonna bring out our long liner brush. It is from a company called Wistonier or something like that, but it is in the description. I got this off of Amazon. It comes with a set, and I love these liner brushes. I used to use Beatles, and I feel like these are better than Beatles, hands down. Not gonna hold you. Get these, don't get Beatles. Beatles is good to start out with, but I feel like these are so much thinner. And if you use Beatles, I feel like you just need to cut out a lot of the hairs because they're pretty thick. You can't get really precise lines with the Beatles ones, in my opinion, until you cut them up. But anywho, this is fairly simple nail art. On two of the nails, we're gonna do this white slanted line like so. And then we're gonna fill it in with some cow print and do some crop print on the other fingers. And orange is the main color. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do this nail art and hush my mouth.
Question, but then no get the answer.
Alright, so we are going to go ahead and top coat the nails before we do our croc print. I just find it easier to go ahead and put the top coat on first instead of trying to go around the croc print. So this is the gel shiny top coat from Cupa. I really do really like this top coat. Ever since I started using it, I really haven't tried anything else, and I don't think I want to because it is bomb.com. It is not as thick as a lot of the other ones are, but it's not too runny, if that makes sense. And as you can see, baby, she is shining like a brand new car. So yeah, we're just gonna go ahead and top coat all the nails, and then the nails that have the orange Frenchie on it, we're gonna go ahead and do the croc print on that, and then we shall return. Alright, so as you guys can see, we are just doing the croc print, which is pretty much putting lines on top of the Frenchie with the same color, and then I'm just gonna pour a clear acrylic on top of it. So it's nothing fancy, and then you just cure it, and then we're gonna wipe it off, wipe off the excess acrylic after it's done. So we're just dusting off that acrylic, and as you can see, I am in love with these already. I could have just stopped there, but I just need a little bit more razzle dazzle. So I am just cleaning up a little bit first before I pull out the charms, because when it's time to take pictures, it's time to take pictures. I don't have time to be cleaning up, so when it's done, it's done. So we're just gonna go ahead and get all this out of the way real quick. Side note, guys, make sure you clean your brushes after every use. You can use acetone or alcohol, but if you don't clean them after each time, they will get crusty and your nail art will look a mess, and your brush is not going to flow the way it needs to. So just make sure you clean them. So now I'm just pulling out my charms to see exactly which one I want to put on here. These are some designer charms. And I'm just going to play with them for a second to see exactly which one fits better. I feel like pretty much all of them looked good, but in the end, only one of them could be a winner. I'm sorry, y'all. I know y'all probably like, dang, girl, just pick one. So this is our McCart rhinestone glue. This is my holy grail. Your charms are not gonna go anywhere with this stuff. It is chef's kiss. So I'm just gonna put a little blob right there to make my final decision so they can actually stick and I can see it a little bit better. So yeah, we're just again, we're still stuck in between this Louis and this Chanel one. So I did like this one too. I feel like it doesn't really matter what you put there. It's just all about what you are looking for. But yeah, I just ended up going with the Chanel one. I don't know, it just fit right there so perfectly to me. So that's why I chose that one. But right here, I'm just cleaning up a little bit of that extra glue since I took a charm off and then put another one on. But yeah, I was satisfied. So this is the one we're gonna stick with. Alright, and I am using my mini LED light. I got this from Amazon. It's just very convenient for me when I'm doing charms because it is so easy to go ahead and cure them before they can have a chance to move before you put them in the light. So yeah, get you guys one. Like I said, it came from Amazon. All right, while we were putting everything up, I did decide to go ahead and switch these charms over to my charm box or whatever you want to call it. I get these from Michaels. I just feel like they're very convenient to access your charms as well as display them to your clients. You can just show them the box. They can see right through and they can pick what they want. So yeah, I'm just moving that over because when they're not in this box, I totally forget about them. But yeah, that is pretty much it for this look, guys. As always, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And comment, guys. Comment and tell me what you guys want to see me do next. But thank you guys. As always, here's the clip at the end of the final result. And I'll see you guys in my next one.